mic today. Hi, Ella. Hi, Debbie. Up Nurse. Hi, Gwen. Bunny. Army. Hi, Bin. Oh, rushing around trying to get everything ready. Plus, the guy across the street was doing his lawn, so thank God he finished. Hi, Patty. Hi, Renee. Hi, Army. All right, so I have a couple things to show you before we get started. Hi, Jenny. Jenny, I'll mod you if that's okay. Oh, there's Dawn. I was going to say, there she is. I know Barry said she's going to be a little late. Hi, Mitz. All right, so let me move this. I want to make sure I don't ruin this. Get out of here. And I did reach 200 followers on my YouTube, so I am going to give a little giveaway. And what you have to do is go to my blog, and then I'm gonna. What you'll do is you'll leave a comment under today's posting, and then I will pick somebody for next week. So I have three things I'm going to give away, if I can find them. So since we're working with mixed media, I'm going to give away these stencils. I have this one, Tim's. I have this one. And I have this one. This one's a really rare one. I think Prima said that they're totally out of this one. So the lucky person to get this will be so happy. So what you have to do is go to my blog. Let me give you my blog. And leave a comment there, and then I will pick three people from that. So let me get you the right thing. Copy. Paste. There you go. So leave a comment there for your chance to win one of those stencils. Oh, thank you, Mitz. It's so nice of you guys to subscribe. I can't believe I have 200, and I forget what my Ustream is, like two something, I forget. So, it's very nice for you guys to take the time to see me. You have video now, Deb? You can't see. Well, I'll post it again. And that'll be for the three masks. It'll be for Tim's, and then this Prima one, Sunset Sunrise, and then this wood grain one. I'm censored! Oh no! Okay, hold on, I'll get it. I thought I allowed links. Oh, there we go. Sorry! Let's try it again. There you go. So just leave a comment under there, and then I'll pick a winner. So you'll have until next Tuesday, and then I'll pick a winner from there. Yeah, they're really pretty, aren't they? Okay, good. So the first thing I want to show you is, did you go over to Scrappadabadoo's blog today? Did you get a look at what I did there? So this is, it must be hard to see the mirror there. This is a graphic 45 tag, and then I took the craft hex, and I bend the little wings here so that it could stand up like that. Isn't it cute? Cute little quick little gift. I have a gift I want to give somebody on Sunday. So, and then I just rubbed it with some Inca Gold, but it's blue. You saw it? Yes. Oh, you're back now, Dawn. Okay. So, and then these are the little mini roses from My Favorite Things, and then some seam binding. So it's really cute. It's just real quick. Didn't take long to do, and then I just sprayed it with some Lindy's. So So that was that. I'll put that away. And then, well, I thought I had something else to show you guys. Well, maybe it'll come up later. All right, so I have to have all my paste. And since we're doing a canvas, I need my... Oh, thank you, Patty. So we will need... Oh, yes, I know what I want to show you. So next week we're going to do a start on a mini. And it's going to be with this, The Simple Stories, A Charmed Life. So it's with this, A Charmed Life. It's nice because it's got blue and green and it's good for boys. So we're going to use this stencil here. We're going to put some mixed media on the front cover. I'm going to show you how to make the camera die. So if you saw these, you love the mermaid, thank you. If you saw these on Facebook, if you have the envelope punch board, you can make these. And that's how I made them. So I'll give you the dimensions next week. It's very easy. We just punch three times and then just cut and then use the corner. And then this is just a heart die. You want the camera die? If you have the envelope board, Ella, you can make this. I'm going to show you how to do it next week. And this one's super simple because it's just two cuts here. And then I just trim this part off. So I'll show you how to do that. No, we're going to make them next week. And then this is going to be like a pocket. And this will go in and out, the flash. So I'll show you how to do those next week. You do, then you can make this. I'll give you all the dimensions next week. And you can make, we'll make two different sizes. That littler one and the bigger one. Oh, thank you, Debbie. All right, so let me get my mat out. And I have so much stuff on my desk, so I have to kind of like scoot everything around. It is cute, isn't it? I have to tell you, when if you guys have Kathy Orta's book, when I saw the camera on the front of that book, I'm like, oh my gosh, I bet we could do that with the envelope board. And I did. So, and I have a pink camera, that's why I did one pink. But you could do any color. So we'll either do, I don't know, a blue or yellow one. We'll see next week. All right. You saw the mermaid stamp? Yep, that's right. So, all right. So let me move that. Tonight we're going to use some of these. And I thought I had bought two of these, and do you guys know why I need two of everything? It's because I'm a Libra, and I have to have the balance, so, but I only had one. I can't believe I didn't get two of these, but we'll see. I might have it somewhere else and just can't find it. So we're going to use these. We're going to use some shells, which I want to gesso. Do you have a camera die? It is a lot faster to do that. It's so quick, you won't believe it. All right, what else do we need? Make some of these. I just want to push some stuff out of here so I could push this, mat in more. I have so many paints and stuff. I just brought everything. I have, I do have to get organized. I've been trying to put like my stamping stuff downstairs, but I have to bring my dies and my die machine up here, so I'm still in the process of doing that. Hi, Star. Hi, everyone who came in. So remind me later to post my blog again, and then this way you can guys have a chance to win those stencils. All right, so we have this. We need a cup. Hi, Mama. All right, so we'll lift this up. Put this here. Hi, Jess. Move this over. I should have done this before, but like I said, I was running around like a mad woman. You'll post it, see? Post it, Dawn. Thank you. Yep, just leave a comment and then you'll have a chance to win. All right, so we're going to use the paper clay tonight. And I need... So what I did... Let me find my sample here. These shell resins, I got them when I was out at Art Venture. I think, I'm not sure if they're out yet or not. They should be. They have the Shoreline is out, so it should be. When Barry comes in, I'll have to ask her if they're out yet. All right, so we have that. I'm looking for my, here it is. All right, so we're going to use those and that. And then I want to gesso. Did any of these? Hi, Donna. Yeah, that's what it's. I thought I bought two of those. Of course, I can't find it. So it's just like, I don't know where it is. But I do have. I hope I have two, because then this way I'll be happy when I find the other one. They're sold out everywhere. Oh no. Well, I know their Prima stuff is coming at the end of the week. So look for it then. They might have it. So I think we're gonna use some of this. And this. Did any of you guys see the Prima live yesterday? I think it was yesterday, Tuesday, yeah, with Frank, and how he painted his shells and he did the seashore tags. Oh my gosh, they were so pretty. Hi, Kathleen. Hi, PM. All right, so let me get my gesso. And then. We'll paint these up real quick. I have water. You saw Frank's tags? Oh my gosh, I have to do those tags. We'll have to do them one night. I'm dying to find out how the sprays are now, because I used them at CHA and they had a little bit of a problem clogging. But they say now when you first get it to unscrew it and then just go like this when you first get it. You know, go back and forth like that to get any micas out of there and then shake it up and they say they have no problem. Frank uses it all the time. He doesn't look like he has any problem. So that would be great. Yeah, I want to do the tags. I think they'll be awesome. All right. Yeah, and I know Barry and Carol are getting the Prima order in, so... Maybe we could do it next week. Depends on how fast I get. If not, we could do it the week after. So we'll see. Oh, and the voice. Yeah, I watch the voice too. All right, so let's put a little water in here. Oops. Hi, Bliss. Can't type tonight, Gwen. All right, I need to get a little bit more room. Move these out of the way. So we're just going to paint these up real quick. Let me spray some water in here. Ah! Hi, Elaine. Oh, the BBs? They have some BBs in there, so I don't know. But they look like every time somebody uses them now on Prima, they don't look like they have any problems, so that's good. I just want to give it a light coat, and then hopefully we can get them to dry. These are kind of white already, so we don't have to do those. I just loved how he did that. It's like, oh, I wish I had those sprays now, don't you? But we're just going to do it with Lindy's and see what happens. Frank Garcia from Prima. He does, on Tuesday afternoons, he's usually, does a live Prima show. And he was, doing the Seashore collection. with the shells, and it was, oh my gosh, his tags were so nice. Oh, the copper won't rust. That's a good tip. So I'll paint these up real quick. And hopefully they'll dry. Yeah, I have, I did some paper ones. I have a paper mold, and I probably should have done that, but since this is a canvas, it should be all right. It's just so that they're kind of mostly all white. I just loved how he did that. Who would ever think to paint the shells? I didn't. I don't know if we'll use them all. I'm doing two small canvases because this canvas is going to be for my daughter's friend. She just moved into the shore, and she wants to hang something from her walls and then put necklaces. So I'll probably put like little brads or something on the bottom of this so that she'll be able to hang her necklaces on there. I'm using gesso. It's just white gesso. And I mixed it with a little bit of water. I just want to give them a light coat so that when we get to spray it, and of course I'm not doing the white ones. So we'll put them away. I should bring some of my wipes out. You can use acrylic paint, but I just use gesso. I had some gesso, so any kind of gesso. This is what I used. Can you see it? All right, so let's clean that up. And I brought a plate so we could lay them on. Oh, and I have a sand dollar, too. This is actual dollar from our beach up the street that I dug out of the sand. Well, you can find them now, like May, during May, we could find some sand dollars. So it's pretty cool. All right, so let's put these on here. Ah! Slippery. Leave these brownish. I mean, I can always paint them later, but we'll see. See how it looks. Alright, so I'm going to put these aside for them to dry. We might have to hit them with the heat gun later. We'll see. Oops. I have Tim's seahorse and the seashell. I probably should use that. It's downstairs, though. I don't know, maybe we'll see. My fingers are gonna be really like yucky all day. I should have brought that stamp up. Maybe I'll have to go down and get it. Use liquid text. I do too. The other one, the guy Rossi, his is kind of watery, so I don't really like to use that one. I really like the liquid text better. All right, so we're gonna get started, and then when you first open up, and I think we might need more than that, so I'm gonna open up my other pack. first open it up, you want to keep it in a Ziploc bag. And so then we're going to use this today. So I'll take that one out, put this one in. And it dries up pretty quick. And I have these lights, these big lights. And you want to just squirt, just a couple of squirts in the bag, just to keep it moist. And then just work with it kind of closed, you know, while you're working. Let me put this in first, and I want to show you what I did first. So let's just close that up first. So now, can you see? This is parchment paper. I don't know if you can see that she's stamped on there. Let me see if I have my other one. So we took this mermaid stamp, and I'm looking for my other paper. Let's see, here it is. So you see, I took parchment paper and then just stamped it. Yeah, you'll find that's right, your little shell birds inside. Some of them fell out though, I think. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to take some parchment paper and stamp the mermaid on there. This is what I did. And then the very first one I did, I wanted to wrap around like a bottle. So you can see, and it depends too on how thick you make your mermaid. So I really made it too thin the very first time, so she did break apart. So you can see here, I want her to wrap around. And then, let me see if I could get her to sit. So I had done it like this. And then she broke. So I just went, oh, and I just broke her tail. But you see, it's too thin. You definitely have to. And then here's her head. But it's okay because you're just going to glue it. You know, you can just glue it right on. And I'm going to glue it around the surface anyway. So it's fine for me that, you know, it's all in pieces. So now when I did the one for today, what I did was, and you can see this one's a lot thicker. It's not as thin as the other. So you really do want to make it like a little less than 1/4 inch thick. So see. And then her little tail also fell off. But she's pretty close to this one. I really like the mermaid with the long kind of flowing hair. So that's the way I'm going to do it tonight. So this is the one we'll use tonight when we paint her up because it's all dry. I did this Monday night and it took 3 days for it to actually dry. So I'll put that over there. Move this so it doesn't get in the way. All right. So now what we're going to do is you're going to... I wonder if you could see. Can you see it? You can't really. Maybe I'll use the other one so you could see it. You can kind of see her. A lot better anyway. So let me just trim it a little. So what you want to do is you want to start with the neck and the shoulders. So that's what we're going to start first. So let me break a piece off here. There. Hi, Miss Deborah. Hi, anybody came in that I missed? All right. So it's so soft. It's not like, and it's very light. It's not like, what do you call the other clay? The Sculpey clay. It's so hard. I can't even do it with my hands. And you know, my hands are pretty weak. Yes. If I put it in the oven, but I didn't, I just let it dry, air dry. And 3 days, it was pretty well dry. So what I'm going to do is I want to form the neck and the shoulders. So I'm going to pull a little piece off. And I'm just going to mold it with my hands. So you just want to make like a neck, like that. And then her shoulders are like pretty high up. So I'm going to pull a little bit more off of there. And you're just going to follow just the pattern. It's just like if you were, you know, coloring. So then you're just going to mush it like this. Do the neck. So just like that. And then we want to follow the line. So you want to come in. Her body is pretty skinny. Don't we wish we all had bodies like her? Femo. Thank you, Bunny. Yes. It's just kind of like Femo. So there we go. So we have that. And then we want to continue down to her waist. So I'm just going to knead it a little bit. And I just kind of put it into like a point. So we're just going to continue and rub it right in. And I'll tear some away if I have too much. And you're just going to stay right within those lines. Pull a little bit more off. So pretty much when you have it like you want it. And come in here a little bit. Then you want to take the brush and let me clean this off a little. And a paper towel. And you want to really smooth the lines. Maybe I should bring you in a little bit closer. Cold porcelain? No, I haven't. How? I've never heard of it. Let's see if I bring it in a little bit closer. There we go. There we go. Now, is that for like doing dolls, like white porcelain dolls? So then you want to make sure you smooth out all these lines. Because when you go to paint it, it's going to show. And then I smooth it out with my finger. Make sure she's all nice and smooth. There we go. Hi, Ash. So then we're going to continue with her arms. So I'm going to move her down a little bit. Like, I don't really like her shoulders up that high, and I covered it with the hair anyway. So just as long as you have some idea. And then I also take these little tools and just kind of like shape her a little. Like that. So then you just want to take a piece now and just make like a little roll here. And then I just break it in half and use half for one side and half for the other. So now when I get down, you just want to follow her shoulder, so you're going to put this right on top of her shoulder like that, and then just follow and thin out her hand. And then right where her elbow is, you want to just come in a little bit. And I'll pull a little bit off more for her hand. So when I kind of put like, think of the muscle, you know, of your arm. So you want to give her like a little bit of a muscle there and then a little bit muscle there. And then when you come in here for her hand, you know, your wrist comes in a little. So you want to bring her wrist in here. And then I kind of flatten her hand out. You could leave her hand like that, but if you see, what did I do with the other one? I actually gave her fingers. So see how she has fingers on the her hand? So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put fingers on her. So the way you're going to do that is you're not going to do all five fingers. You're just going to do this. You're going to slice it into fours. So you have the little pinky, then the next finger, and then the next. And then I just kind of round these fingers off a little bit. And then you can just shape them. Get another one here. Hi, Barry. I get ya. So then you're just going to shape these little fingers. Like that. So she has four, and in order to put the thumb, you always do the thumb separate. So what you're going to do is you're going to just roll a little piece, kind of like a cigar. So see, it's, and even that's too big. So I'm going to take that a little bit off and roll it. So it's kind of like a teardrop. Oops. Let me see if I put it on here. Of course, I ruined it. So kind of like that. Did you see it? And then you're going to put the thinner side down here. And just attach it to her arm. Like that. And I'm going to put some water on there. So we can glue it on there. I'll just lift her hand up a little. Try not to squish the others. So there is her thumb. Remember, you want to squish in her wrist a little bit. And then we want to smooth it out. I don't want any lines in there. Okay, so that's our first arm. Now we're going to do the next. I'm going to stick this piece back in here. Keep that covered. So we'll save those for her fingers. So now we're going to do this arm. Can you see? Hi, Linda. You're doing it right from the stamp. You should be able to do it. You're just following the lines. So we want to put her shoulder in there. And then you're just going to follow. Remember, make her little muscle and then come in and then bring her hand down. I might have to add a little bit more for her hand. So make sure I put that in really good because you don't want it to fall apart. So make sure it's in there. And I'm going to cut just a little bit off. Oops. And now's the time if you want to bend it or you want to shape it, however you want to do it, this is the time to do it. All right, so there's her hand again. We came in for her wrist, like that. Okay, Jess, make sure you put your link up, Jess. So you want to divide this into fours. And then I take a little bit off. The hardest part is trying to get the hands, you know, the same. And I don't really worry about it. Okay, so we have the four fingers. And separate them a little bit. And then you want to do the same thing, make the thumb. Hi, Donna. So it's the same thing, gonna make like a little cigar. So see, like a little cigar like that. And then you're gonna add it onto her hand here. You always add the thumb on. It just looks better that way. Just looks more like a real hand. So there we go. Now we want to just run some water on there. Get it all nice and smooth. Make sure that's in there. And we want to rub this in. You want this nice and smooth in here. Because remember, any line that shows when you paint, it's going to show. And we're going to put some seashells for her chest anyway. So that looks pretty good. And then tonight I'm going to cheat a little bit. Where is my... What we're going to do is I want to make another canvas, and I want to use these girls, you know, these girls from Jamie. And what we'll do is we'll actually do the eyes and the nose and the mouth and stuff, because that alone almost takes an hour just to learn how to do that. So she's just going to be kind of a plain face. And I'm actually going to cheat tonight. I have these small with the faces. So I'm going to do one of those and cheat tonight. So I'm going to use this face here. And that should be pretty close. So let's see how that works. Might be, we'll see. I think it's too small. We need a little bit bigger. Maybe this one. I need to add a little bit more. So you want to roll it up in a little ball. And we'll add it on there. There we go. So we're going to add her on like that. I want to put a little water so I can get the neck and the head going. So you don't want to press too hard, because you want you don't want to get her out of shape. So just put her chin in there and kind of mush her in. And she does have a skinny chin. I mean, skinny neck, so. And then work around and put her on. We'll put her hair on. So that's how she looks so far. It's not cheating. But doesn't she look good now with the face? Oh, hi, D4B. So we have her in there pretty good. And just smooth it all out. And squish her down a little. And like I said, it's no big deal if she falls apart a little bit. You're just going to glue her down anyway. So she's looking pretty good. So now we're going to do her tail part. Yeah, because you could take any stamp. We definitely have to try these girls with the stamps and actually make their face and stuff. Wouldn't that be cool? And we could actually do the flowers. So we'll have to do that. I actually want to do three canvases with the three girls and put art and have each one have a letter. Wouldn't that be good? I want to hang that up. So we'll do that one day. All right, so now for her tail. You just have to stay. It's like coloring. You just have to stay in the lines. You guys could do it. All right, so we want to pull a big enough piece. I don't think that's big enough. Okay. So now she has this big kind of like hump for her butt. So you just want to kind of, you know, it's kind of like a teardrop, you know, like a, you just have to follow it. So you're just going to go along and then just stretch it out. Oh, I'm off camera. So you're going to go along. This is her little butt here. And then you're just going to keep stretching this out. You know, she has a little skinny waist. So you're just going to keep moving it. So see, just like that. And then you're just going to stay right in the lines. So you're going to add that onto her like that. And her butt's just up a little bit higher. And you just move it along. And just stay right within the lines. And this one I made just a little bit too thick. So let's bring her down a little. Can you see? Hi, Miss Pris. So she looks pretty good. I'll move her hand out a little bit. And then we're going to use the water again. Smooth this all out. Rub that in so they blend together. I still need to bring this down a little. There, now she's looking pretty good. Are those Prima molds? This one? No, it's, oh, I don't know. American Art Clay? Can you see it, Barry? Let me put the focus on. Oh, the resin shells. Okay, that's what they're asking for. This is, yes, these are Prima. There's Shabby Chic Treasures. There's this one with the seahorse. That's that item number. Well, you can't see it. 891985. So that's the one with the seahorse and the crabs. And then this one is the seashells. It's from the seashore line, yes. And this one is 891978. So that's them. All right, so we have that down pretty good. And now we're going to do the tail. So we need some more of that. Yes, they are. They are, Patty. They're from Ingenving Bloom. I don't know how to say her name. Yeah, I love the shells. Well, I love the crabs, too, and the seahorses. They're really cute. All right. So now we got her tail to go. So see, she's coming along pretty good. See? And all it is just following, we're just following the stamp. So now you just want to make two, like, leaves, like. So you know how to do a leaf. Just want to make a point at the end. And I kind of like my tails a little bit more pointy and more round. So see, it looks kind of like a leaf. See? And then we're just going to attach it to this. Let me get some water. Add some water on there. And then you're just going to attach it like that. And then just shape it however you want. And then we'll come in here with this. Just bring it in a little bit more. And I kind of like to like round in her tail a little bit. And then I put these little So it's just kind of like a leaf. So, and then we're just going to do the next one the same. So we need some more of that. So it's the same thing. Just rub this around a little. Make your other leaf. And then you're just going to add it to the bottom here. Right on top of there. Like that. Make this little point. And then I'm going to do the same thing. Make this kind of like a bump. Is it this one I do on the other side? Let me see. That side. So it would be nice to celebrate. And like I said, it's kind of like coloring when you're coloring. You're just keeping the clay within the mold, you know? So. And this tail's just a little bigger than I'd like. So let's just push that up. So we have it like this. And I'm just going to do the same thing. Add the little dents in there. And then we want to smooth that out a little. Remember, any wrinkles you have will show, so you want to smooth it out. All right. So now we're ready. Oh, and let me show you. So you could take anything to create the this part of her. You wanted to do dots or, I need to put her little band. I gave her a little waistband. It's not like coloring. It's kind of like coloring. So you want to make another little cigar lake. So see, it's just like a little cigar, and then you're just going to form that for her waist. I'll give her a waist there. So this one comes down, and then we need another one. No sound. Yes, it's being recorded. Can you hear? Thank you. Maybe you have to refresh, Miss Pris. Can you guys hear me? It's recording. Okay, so I want to pull a little bit off of here. And so again, you're just making another little cigar-like, teardrop-like, and then you're going to make her waist again. And then I just want to blend this together. I'll use this. So kind of like a heart, kind of like. I'm gonna blend this side. And then for the tail part, all I did was I took this part. Let me get a wipey. Kind of looks like a merman now, doesn't he? Without the hair. Yeah, the clay is really easy to work with. All right. And then for this part, all I did was I just took the tip of this and just kind of pressed down. So you just want to not go really deep, but and just press around. And then you just want to go in between those that you just did. And I mean, if you were really creative, you could do little tiny leaves and put leaves on her. And, you know, you can do all kinds of stuff with her tail part. But I just do this. If you just let it air dry, it took 3 days, but you could put it in the, oven. I mean, not your oven. Do not put it in your oven. If you had a, clay oven, you could stick it in there at like 250 and probably, I don't know, maybe 40 minutes. It depends on how thick it is. Like, I really made this tail thick compared to the other one. So I just, put it in a window and I, just let the sun kind of air dry it. So 3 days and it was pretty well done. There you go. So that's how you do her tail. And it's kind of a little bit out of shape. So you just go back in, just smooth it out. And then you can also sand it too. I mean, if you found any pieces that you didn't really like, you would be able to sand it. So, see? You guys could do that. Easy. All right, for her hair now. I like her hair kind of long and flowy. So what I do is I start with, I really don't, I kind of follow that, but I don't really. So what I do now is I take a little piece, and you think of, you know, how your hair is parted in the middle. So just, you can just draw a little line like that where it's parted. And then what I do is I take like a little, I don't know what you call, like a nickel size, and just kind of like split it in half. And then what you want to do is I kind of give her like long bangs, I guess you want to call it. So let me show you the other one that I have, so you can see what I mean. So see here, let me put it on autofocus for you guys. There we go. So see here, I put two pieces that go down like this, that just cover really the top of her head. Can't really get that focused, so let's see. There you go. And I see this one I still need to sand and stuff, but you get the idea. So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to do that. And I do kind of like, I don't know, a half a circle, if you want to call it. And so I lay that. This is even too big. I'm going to take a little bit off of this and reform it. What's so funny? Hi, Jonah. You can't chat. You're out walking. Okay, good. All right. So now we have that like that for her head. So then I'm going to lay that right down. I still want, it's too thick for me. I want to get a little bit thinner. Oops. There. So see, it still looks kind of like a half a circle or half oval. There we go. And I'm going to lay that right down over her head like this. Oh, and I need to put some water so it'll attach. So you want to get some water underneath here and on here. And then we're going to press that right on. So you don't want to have too big a bouffant hairdo. And I just kind of put that right around her head. So see? Just like that. Aunt Maggie! Alright, and so then we're going to do the same thing with the other side. Just like a half a circle. We're going to wet her head on this side. Put some water on this. And then you're going to put this on this side like this. So let me just flip around so I can see. So you have the part in the middle there like that. And then I just kind of draw lines just like you would your hair. You know, your hair just comes down. You just want to make lines like that. So that's her hair right there so far. So now for this part, I just want to make long hair. I mean, you could follow the doll, but I just prefer the long, long, long hair. So that's what I'm going to do. So now what I'm going to do is just kind of do, I guess, like a leaf again, you want to say, like a long leaf. So see, like this. And then I am going to lift her up. I'm going to add some water on her. So I'm going to put some water on here. And then I'm going to lift her up with my, move this over, my tool here. I don't want to mess her up too much. I'm going to add some water underneath there. And then I'm going to add her hair here. And then you're just going to shape it now. Like I want it, I want to press down this hair. I want it to go down behind her neck. So I'm going to press it so it goes behind her neck. You want it attached to here. So I want it to come up and around. Can you see? Yeah. up and around her head there. And then I want it to come down kind of like a point. So you want it to come all the way down to her neck, like that. And then you're just going to just continue to draw lines in there, just like your, you know, your hair would be. So that's one end, like that. And then I want to make, you know, get her hair all blended here, down here. So we want to blend it. And then I kind of push it in to make it kind of wavy, a little. And coming down. And now it's just a matter of how long you want it, how big you want it. So we want to get some hair on our other side. So we're going to do the same thing. Now, this is where you could decide if you don't like her shoulders, then you can put her hair over her shoulders. If you like her shoulders, then you could keep it. And the one that I did, I really didn't care for her one shoulder on this side. See? So I covered it. So you could decide what you want to do. Keep the shoulders or go over the shoulders. What is that? Mermaid's a belly button. What is that, Dawn? She has a link in there. Mermaids have belly buttons. I'll have to look at it later. So you want me to put a belly? I did put a belly button in the other one. So there, we have our little belly button in there. Thanks, Barry. All right, so we're going to continue with our hair. So, again, I'm going to add some water. So it's kind of like our glue. I'm going to add some water behind her here. And then I'm going to lift her up a little bit and stick her down. I don't know. I think I'm going to keep her shoulder this time. So let's see. So we want to come around. I want to draw her hair down. And she looks good with short hair, kind of, right? I think maybe I'm going to make it a little bit longer. So let's see. I'm going to add another, kind of like a leaf. And I'm going to just pull a little bit off. So like I said, now it's up to you to decide how long you want her hair, how much hair you want her to have. That's all what you want now. And I like to give her like waves. So we have a wave there. One there. And then we got some more water here. And then I'm going to add just another little piece over there. I put the belly button there. She looks cute with the belly button. I had a belly button on my other one, too. All right. So then we're going to add just a little bit more hair on here. So let's add some more water. Water on here. Again, we want that kind of like over her shoulder a little bit, coming down and into a little point. Around it. I want to just push it down and by her neck a little bit more. So I think she's looking pretty good now. Get some of these wrinkles out. There. So, you like her? There she is. With her little belly button. I like her with the face. The other one, my other one, doesn't have a face. But she looks pretty cool with the face, doesn't she? There she is. Oh, come on, focus. 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 Come on. There we go. There's her little belly button, Dawn. She looks good, doesn't she? So now I'm going to put her away to dry, and then we're going to work on the other one, and we'll work on our canvas. Thank you. Thank you, guys. All right, so I'm going to put her away, and then we're going to work on this one. I'll let her dry. Let's see. Where can I put her? We'll close up our clay. Well, she's going to have little seashells. I'm going to put seashells on her for her chest. That's what we have to do for this one. Yeah, she does. So it's not too bad. In an hour, pretty much an hour, we had her done. And then you just have to let her dry, unless you can, you know, have a baking thing. And then, like I said, this is the time you want to fix her hands. If you want to move them, if you like them the way they are, you want them out a little bit more, this is the time to do it. And then see, she's still kind of wrinkled there a little bit. So I want to just smooth out her wrist there. So I think she looks pretty good. I think I'm just going to leave her like that. Can put her hand up a little if she's going to be sitting on something. So there she goes. So, and then I'm just going to put a little dent in here a little more. Oh, thank you, Tab. Thank. It's like I said, I mean, I'm dying to do the other faces. So let me get her out of the way. I'll just stick her right here for now. So now we want to, she's a hair beast shell. All right, so we have that. So let me clean this up and get our canvases going. And get rid of this. This worked out really well. I like that. So we can put this away. Yeah, I could just make, but she's all, this one's nice and hard now, so, see, and I had her hands separated, but I must have moved her at some point, because now it's kind of, she's kind of like on her lap, which is fine. Mm. Yeah, don't you wish you could smooth out wrinkles that easy? Oh, bye, Vic, thanks for coming. Thanks for joining me. All right. So don't forget, Dawn, can you post it again? You have a chance to win the 3 stencils if you leave a comment on my blog on this post. And I reached 200 followers on my YouTube channel, so you're going to get a chance to win this, or a chance to win this one, or a chance to win that. And you'll have till next Tuesday, you know, to leave a comment, and then I'll pick next Wednesday, I'll pick the winners for those. All right, so let's get rid of this and this. We can get rid of these. Need that. This. Thank you, Dawn. All right, so now we have her. She's all nice and hard. I am going to give her a quick thing of gesso, because I want to paint over her with the gelato. You could paint over, if you didn't If we didn't want to paint, I'm going to paint with gelatos tonight. So, but if you didn't and you just use regular paint, you wouldn't have to put gesso on her. But because she's so porous, I want to give her a quick coat of gesso. And then we'll dry her. Thank you, Perry. So let's just paint her up real quick. And I'll have to get my heat gun out to dry her. And you can see here, it shrunk up just a little bit because this was touching her shoulder. And now it's kind of has a little hole there. But we can fix it. Oh, you almost can't see her belly button there. So you could even do this with her other dolls. You know, if you wanted to do like a clay doll, just her regular stamp dolls, and do this. All right, Mr. Hand. There. Okay, we did that, and then we'll also just hit it with the heat gun, and then also hit our shells with the heat gun too. So let's just clean this up. So we might just be able to paint her up. I don't know if we'll be able, we'll see if we can get her on a canvas real quick. Just cleaning my hands real quick and get some of this off. All right. So I hit her with the heat gun, and I also want to do the shells too at the same time. So some of them are pretty dry. Some of them are a little wet. So let's put that there and that. Looks better with the face, doesn't she? I like her better with the face. All right, that should be good. So, stick her out. We don't need this right now. Anyway, the brush, let's see where that is. My other brush. I'm gonna use this one. And the gelatos. Paint her skin. I want a little bit of the pink. Maybe we'll go with orange or this pink. This. Maybe a little brown. So I'm going to paint her skin first. So I'm going to get some clean water. they remind you of creepy things. Yeah, because look how much, I mean, now that she has no face compared to our girl that has a face. Let's see if I bring her over here. Look how much better that looks. I used a mole this time, but, next time we're going to do one of these girls out of clay, and then I'm going to show you how to actually do the eyes and how to make the nose and how to do the lips. So we're going to do one of these on a canvas. So all right, so, and I have this tip from Jonna. Went to the expo. These colors I'm using, and the girl said you could paint with them. I didn't even think about, like, actually painting with them. This one, let's see, this one's called Peach, so we'll do Peach. This one doesn't have a name. Neither does this. It would be nice if they were on the cap or something, but they're not. This is the only one that says Peach. Yes, these are gelatos. So what we want to do is, I want to get some skin color on her. And I think I might go with a little bit darker pink, maybe. Let's see. Kind of yellowish. And then we still have to give her her seashells, too. I was saying, Jonna went to the expo and she saw the girl demoing these, and they were painting with the gelatos. Yeah, we're going to have to give her some seashells. I might have some little seashells here we can put on her. I'm going to just draw some water here. You could use paint too. I just wanted to try it this way. I might switch over to my paint if I find it. It would be quicker. Okay, let's see how she looks. And get the side of her arm. She has a belly button. She's got one. This one's got a really skinny waist. Can you imagine being that skinny? Let me see if I can find my paint. Only because it's going to take me forever with these gelatos. Stick this here. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go with this, and this one is called, which one is this? Seashell pink. I'll keep this out for, I think I'm gonna do some rosiness to her cheeks. I haven't really decided what color hair she should have yet either. Crayons are sold out. Oh my gosh, really? What do you mean by encaustic? I really don't know what that is. I have to look that up. She is too skinny. She is too skinny. I could add some to her. Oh, I need my scissors. Yeah, I made her way too skinny. Maybe not. Okay, let's put a little paint here. There we go. All right, paper towel. I think that's better color for her. Oh, and an encaustic is a pigment that you melt. That's why she was melting the crayons. It's cool. I haven't played with them yet. I got them, but I didn't play with them yet. She's way too skinny. I might have to put some, maybe later on I'll have to put some. She's looking better already. Oh, you have to get the little ones to bed. We switched over from the gelatos to paint. Only because it's faster. Right now. Okay, and then I think I'm going to use a little bit of this for her cheeks, so let's see how that works. Maybe I just put a little bit on there. marker. Can you see? She has a little bit pinker cheeks now. I really don't know what to do her hair. I guess I should do a kind of gold because her friend's got blondish hair. So let's try that. J-Lo Mermaid or Beyonce. She's getting kind of cute. She's just got, I don't know, her waist is way too small. All right. Let me wipe this up. Yeah, I like the one we did with the face, too, but oh well. I might put a face on her later, maybe. So, let me get some water, more water. Brown and gold highlights. Let's see how it goes. This one's, I think, the gold metallic. It's really pretty. Pink would look good with the green tail. We're definitely going to put green tail on her. Greenish blue, like. She doesn't want it too dark because her room is kind of like a teal blue. So she doesn't want a lot of dark colors. No, thank you, Star. She's looking good with the blonde hair. She'll like it because she's got blondish hair. And I get it on her skin. There we go. Looking pretty cute. Now her room is like a teal color, and so she doesn't want, like, you know how the one I showed you last week is kind of like a dark blue and dark green? She wants it kind of more soft, like sky blue and a little bit more softer. So we won't make her too dark. And I think she needs a little glitter in her hair, so let's put some stickles on there. She's a mermaid. You see her glittery? She looks cute with her hair. I'll bring her up close so you can see in a minute. I like her with the glitter hair. There, that's good enough. I'll put a little bit in here. Okay, so here's what she looks like up close. Let me get some. I have something dark I could put her on. So you can see. Usually I have my little black mat. Oh, here, I could use one of these. I could use this black thing here to show you. So, you see the glitter in her hair? Doesn't she look cute? Now, it would be better if she had a face, but she's coming along. And see, she does have a belly button. All right, so let's give her some seashells. And then we'll color her. We'll color her tail. So let's get rid of that. So I have some shells here. This is from Turks and Caicos. We went to Turks and Caicos a couple years back. So, Zippy is ready. Oh, your camper is ready, Jonna. Cool. All right, so let's put some of these shells out. Let's see. This one might be too small. And this one's too big. That's too small. This one's probably good. We can get two the same size. That would be great. Let's see how this one is. So what do you think? Those two look good? I don't think there's, oh wait, maybe this one. I think that one on that side. All right, so that looks good. And then maybe we'll put this little thing in her hair. The little seashell on her hair. How's that? That's cute. See what else we have here. Maybe this little one. We'll just do that one, I think. Or this one. We'll put those two in our hair. How's that? All right. All right, so let's glue those down. I'm going to use this beacon. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Debbie. She's coming along really cute, isn't she? All right, let's get rid of this. And put these on. Raining. Oops. Let me put that one there. Let's take this one down. Ugh, I got glue all over my hands now. So there we go. That doesn't look too bad. And then we'll put these little ones down. So I should put a little drop there. I wish I had tweezers, yeah. Let's put this one down. And then this one. I don't think I have enough glue. I need a little bit more glue. one too. So there she looks. Cute. All right. Now we can paint the rest of her. Oh no, I got paint on my box. All right, so let's put that away. We can put this away. We'll color her tail real quick, and then we can at least try to get her on the canvas. Oh, I can plug you guys in. I can leave you. There we go. All right. Cool girls wear coconuts. Yep, not mermaids. Mermaids have the seashells. All right. So she's looking pretty cute. So let's get on with her tail. So which I think I'm going to try to do some Lindy's on her tail. So this is called Tibetan Poppy Teal. I don't want it too dark, so we'll see how that goes. And I don't want to make a mess. So let me take a piece of this. Let's stick it under her. That's why I won't have such a big mess. So let's clean the brush. I need a paper towel. Let's see what this looks like. Ooh, that's pretty. Can you see her? Get the scissors out of the way. Ooh, that's nice. Now we're getting our hands. I just want to put some light blue on here because I want to get some green on contrast for her tail. So that looks good. Let's get some green in here. Hi, Mickey. So let's try, let's see what else I have here. This one is cement green. Let's try that. Oh, maybe I should take it off out of focus for you guys. I hate when it goes in and out like that. There we go. I want to get her tail kind of more limey green. Oh, that's nice. Oops. And then I'll heat set it in a minute. Let me dry that. Good, Miki. How are you? Just heat that real quick. That's pretty, isn't it, so far? Let's see what else we could throw in here. Let's see. Should do a little orange yellow, maybe? What else do I have? I'm trying to see what else. Let's see. Teal? How about this teal? Do a little bit more teal on her tail. This one's shabby tuck spine teal. Well, let's see what that looks like. Look a little bit in here, just on that darker edge. She needs iridescent. Well, let's just see what I have. I don't have a lot of Lindy's, so we'll see. That's looking pretty good. Put some on this edge here. It is really shiny. I don't know if you guys could see that it is, but it is sparkly. Iridescent. I don't know what I could use for that. Let me see what I have. Let me just heat set that. I gotta get the sides of it. It's kind of like what do I do with the brush? I'll use that color again for the sides. Side of her here. Okay, that's looking pretty cute. Yeah, something else for your clay. Yes, definitely. Yep. This one doesn't have a face, but this one does. This is the one we made tonight. And you can see she's starting to already turn, starting to dry. Like her tail is starting to get white. But see, we put a face on ours tonight. But she's not ready yet. All right, so I think she's looking pretty good. We don't want to make her too dark. I'm trying to see if I have anything like really sparkly. Unless we put stickles on her. That's about the only thing. How about if we put some of this green stickles on here? Let's see. Sparkly flakes. We're going to use some sparkly flakes on the canvas. Let me see if I can get this come out. Of course, it doesn't want to. Let me show you first before I do that how sparkly she is. She's looking really nice. So let's see if I can get her up on here. So let me put it on autofocus so you can see. She's coming out really good, isn't she? There we go. So see her hair. Oh, come on. Come on, camera. Come on. There we go. So there she is. She has way too skinny of a waist, though. And then here's her tail. Her tail's... I don't know if you can see how sparkly. It is pretty sparkly. But... come on. There you go. Oh, the perfect pearls? I don't know if I have them up. I do have some. I'm trying to think of where they are. Okay, so let's see. You know, I got... Let me see if I have it up here. Let me see what I got. Oh, you know what I have? I have some silks. Here, Dawn, I had this. Maybe you could tell us how to use it. I don't know. I got it when I was at CHA. So here I got some. We could put some stickles on her. I'll tell you what these are, and then you can tell me how to use it. How's that? These are... One is a polished pigment, one is a silk, and one is a twinkly H2O. So I got this in my Prima Art Venture bag. But, of course, I never used it because I don't know how to use it. You'll hand me some magical mica? Oh, I have some of those, I think. How about if we put the silk on there? That should be pretty, right? The silk? Or what about this? What is this, Dawn? Primary elements. Do you know what that is? That's kind of like, what do you call it, isn't it? This one's called Spanish Moss. I don't know, I got it in my bag, Barry, so I don't know, like, how to use it or what it is. Let's see. Well, let's see how this works. Ooh, that's kind of greenish. That's sparkly. Can you see it? Oh, that's pretty. That's very sparkly. I think it's kind of like, what do you call it? Pearls. That's sparkly. Can you see that? Where's the bag? See, it's sparkly. Yeah, it's pretty, right? Should add some maybe on her tail. A little bit in here. For like her scales. Just here and there. Ooh, that's pretty. That's nice and sparkly, right? So let's just add a little bit of glitter on here. Just put a little bit on her, scales too. There we go. We got a little bit of glitter on her tail. Mm-hmm. Hi, Mermaid. Oh, you are so late. Okay, so I think she looked pretty good. Kind of all sparkly. I don't know if I should put a little bit on her. Just a little bit here and there on her scales. There. Oh, it does? Well, it came out pretty good. I mean, it looks good the way we have it there. Should we put the silk over it? Mm-hmm. Now she looks nice and sparkly, look. See her? She's glittery now. This looks good. Hi Jean Marie. She looked better than you. All right, so I think she's looking pretty good. So let's put her on the canvas if we could get her on there. Now, should I put some of this on there, Dawn? The silk? I think it just adds like another layer, right? The silk is a paint, but it's like a translucent paint, isn't it? I've never really used it before. Should I put it on there? Vote yes or no. So just leave it the way she is? Yes, you'll have to watch the recording, uh-huh. We did another one earlier, and this one has no face, but this one looks so much better with the face. So see. This one has a face. See? And she looks a lot prettier with the face. And she has a belly button. That one has a belly button too, but you can't really see it. Just leave it? Okay, I'll just leave it. All right, so let's get to the canvas really quick. So she's all done. I think she looks fabulous. I love her. But now, don't you hate when you do something like this and you have to give it away? Then I'll just make another one. All right. So let me get rid of this. I want to get rid of this water so I don't spill it. Okay, I'm just leaving it. Oh, you got booted. Oh, no. There you go. All right, so let's get rid of all these paints. We're just going to do not a real in-depth canvas because she's kind of a plain, you know, she doesn't like a lot of stuff, and so I'm just not going to go a lot crazy with the canvas. So I already pre-gessoed it, so which is good. So what we have to decide is, do we want to put our mermaid this way? Oh, let me get it off of autofocus. Let me move you guys back a little. Off of there. There. And then I would leave the silk off. That's what they decided, and that's what we did. You're right, I have another one ready to go, so, and that one has the face, so that's nice, so. All right, so should we put her this way? And I'm going to write some type of saying, I don't know what I'm going to write, so we can either, I think this way will be good, long ways. And then I'm going to tack some stuff at the bottom here, because she wants to put, hang jewelry and stuff. So I think we're going to put her this way, and then I'll tack some things on here where she could dangle stuff. Oh, the silk on the blue one. When it dries, maybe I will. So we just want to, I want to do like a little collage. So let's get our, I want to just have a guess about where she's going to be. And then I do want to, put some seashells on here. So let's just take all of this out that we painted earlier. Oh, I'll try the silks on the seashells. How's that? So we have that. And plus, we want to put our seahorse and stuff like that on there. So I know I want to stay on this side, so I want to keep this kind of flat, and then we can go ahead and mess around with this side. So let's go ahead and do that. I made the other mermaid tonight. I made the other one, and that I had one already prepared. We did this one tonight. This, you'll be able to see it in the recording, how she came up. So, make a reef. Yeah, we could do that. All right, so let's move her off. And then I want to add some stuff. So this is some sticky back canvas. I think it's sticky back canvas. I'm not sure. It's, I don't know if I could get it off. We're just going to gesso it down. I want to make it like, kind of like waves, and just to give it some texture. So let me get my gesso out. So let's put this down. And it's okay if there's some color coming through. We're going to color the canvas anyway, and we're going to put some texture paste on here. So we're probably going to go a little bit over. But I want to be able to finish it tonight. So I need some more room. So let's glue this down. Probably should have a bigger brush too. And I'll just bend this over the side. Maybe I'll just cut it off. Bye, D4D. Thanks for coming. Don't forget to leave a comment on my blog for your chance to win the stencils. For those of you who are going. Okay. So we're going to lay that down real quick. I do have some stencils. Let's get those out. I want to be able to put that on there. We'll use this one. And we'll use this. All right, so let me get my homemade texture paste out. Where is that? Right here. Whoops. We're just going to put some crackle, kind of like crackle, and I'm going to put some seaweed on here. So this is my homemade texture paste. And then I need, oh, I don't have my metal, what do you call it up here? Oh, my spatula. Do I? All right, I have to find something hard. Let me see if I have a piece of acrylic that we could just lay it down with that. I'll use this. Ah, I'm putting my stuff right on top. I gotta move her out of the way. She's getting stuff on her. Okay. So we're just gonna add some other stuff real quick, and then we're gonna put a mermaid down and kind of just spray it a little bit. No, I have it on my blog. I don't remember when the post was. I'll have to try to find it, Donna, and then I can either give it to you on Facebook. I just don't know where it is. I should have marked it for tonight, but they didn't. I'm trying to think. Even, I think it's on the Scrap-a-Dab-a-Doo blog. Yes, it is. If you go to the one where I made the doll that says create, there's a place to click on there, and you can go, it'll go take you right to my thing. All right, so let's get this done real quick. So I want to put some texture on here, just so we have a little bit of texture. So let's do that. And I know I want to keep her pretty straight, so we'll just do this here. And I think I need to add a little bit of water. Mine's just a little thick. And I really need my knife. Of course, I don't have it here. I don't know where it is. The, for the texture paste, Dawn, if you go to Scrap-a-Dab-a-Doo and the post I did with the girl, it's a place there. I think it's not, it's like 2 days ago maybe. You know, for the texture, the homemade texture paste. Okay, so let's stick some on here. And this isn't really a good thing, what I'm using, but it's so flexible, but we'll see how it goes. Hi, Darcy. Little bit of texture there, and we want to keep her kind of smooth. Oh, I want to do, let me just wipe this off real quick. Oh gosh, I need more room. Let me see if I could put her on this plate. I'll get most of this off. There, thank you. Thank you, Dawn. That will give you the homemade texture paste. And I actually got it from Gabrielle, who's the Bow Bunny. She's one of the Bow Bunny designers. So let's dry this real quick. And then I want to, let me get my furrow paste. Come on, I wish I knew where my knife was. I usually take this stencil, which is the tree, and I use it to make like seaweed. I've never used it for a tree. So, I'm gonna put, so we know that she's gonna go here, so we wanna get some seaweed down up in here. Although I think I'm going to spray it first. So let's do that first. We'll spray it with some blue and green that we had. Oh, I've got no room. So let's do that. What we used today, we'll use some of this cement green. It's nice. Plus it smells like baby powder, so which is really nice. Got some green on there. Let's get some, I want to try a little bit of this orange, magnolia yellow orange. So let's get a little bit of that on there. So let me heat set that. Yes, I love the drippage. So let's get that going. And I probably would stamp and stuff on here, but I'm just going to do it really quick so that I could get at least most of it done tonight. I want to get some blue in here, so let's see. This is supposed to be bubble. Let's try what this is. This is Tattered Angels, but I want to use it because I have it. So let's try. Of course, it doesn't work. Ugh, can you believe it? It doesn't work. So let's try something else. I don't want to go with the same colors we used in our tail. Well, let's try this. This is flat. T-Bird Turquoise. So let's try that. Oh, I want to get some of these shells, too, we need to do. So let's see. I want to get the sides of this. Can you see? Do that. So that's looking good. So let's do that. We'll heat set that. Oh, can't stay there. You see? Let that dry for a second. Whoops. Ugh, I just touched it. Darn it. Alright. Let's stick that there. I want to get some of these shells. Let's see how well they dye, if they do. Since we want to put some color on there. Let's get some color on here. Some blue, and then we'll try the green. Ooh, that looks nice, doesn't it? Now this one doesn't want to go. Are you serious? All right, that's good. Let's try that. They really have a shine on them now. They look good. Alright, so let's move those over. And then let's do the sand dollar a little bit. I'll squirt this with a little bit of water. Move that around. There, that's looking pretty good. All right, so let's clean this up and then we'll put the canvas together. I'm using Lindy's. Okay. Oh, I want to put the like the seaweed on there, and then we can put it together. All right. So let's bring the canvas back out. And I would probably have stamped on here a little bit and add more color, but for tonight, I'm just going to do it real quick. I'll go around, and before I give it to her, I'll go around and add some other stuff here. So I want to put this on here. Yes, it's Lindy's. Mm-hmm. So let me cover this. I don't need that anymore. Oh, where's my top? There it is. Oh, you know what? I didn't cover some of the, I'll have to spray those real quick. I picture this. It's all recorded, so you can watch the recording. And I hope I have something I can get down. I've really used this bottle a lot. I really just love this color, this orange color. Oops. So as you can tell, it's pretty empty. So let's see what we could do to get in here. Oh, I need something to reach in there. Oh, here we go. Use this. And this is a Ferro golden orange. It's like one of my favorites. So we're going to add that on here. And of course, it would look a lot better, I'm sure, if I had my metal knife, but I can't find it. So I'm using this. So I hope it's just as good. Can you see it? This is Viva Ferro Paste. It's the metal effect color. It's called Golden Orange. This is just a stick. I really should have the metal thing, but of course, you know, I can't find it up here. So I want to cover this really quick. And then watch how cool this looks when we lift it up. Maybe I'll have to go this way. See how that looks like seaweed? Oh my gosh, I love this. It's like my favorite thing to do for underwater. So let's add a little bit more. I don't have an old credit card, nothing. I have nothing up here. I wish I did. I can't find one thing up here to do with. So I have to do this. I have to use this, unfortunately. So let's put some down in here. I mean, it still came out pretty good for using a popsicle stick, so. I just want to get a little bit more on this side. And then we'll put our, it's still kind of wet, so I'm not going to put the mermaid there, but I'll put it so that you guys could see it. And then I'll post pictures on my blog when how I actually finished it. All right, so you ready? Oops, can't see. Oh, I have to glue this down, but look. But doesn't that look like seaweed? It looks very cool. So let me wash this off real quick. But it's like my favorite thing to do. I need another jar of this. It looks like I'm almost out of it. Oh, you're back, Dawn. Let me just wipe that off. I wish I had a credit card here, but I don't. So I'm gonna have to stick it in some water for now I just want to get most of it off. It has a lot of gold, as you can see, a lot of gold metal in it. All right. So, and I would go ahead and dry this, but I just want you to have an idea of how she's going to look now. So she'll go like this. Can you see? So I'll set her in here like this. And I'm probably going to put something here, a word, a saying of some kind. But then we can put all our seashells down in here. So I'll arrange them in here. I want to use the, I should have painted these too. So I'll have to paint these. But I definitely want to use the seahorse and the crab. The little crab I'll have to paint and put them on there. It's coming out really cute, isn't it? So I'll have pictures on my blog when I do the final arrangement. And so you can see how, I wanted you to see how pretty these shells look. But the shells came out really, really sparkly. The Lindy's gangs work perfect on these shells. So let's just, let me get you close so that you could see. Still on focus? Come on. Oh, I don't know if I have it on autofocus. Hold on. Thank you, very nice. Let's see. Nope, not on autofocus. Hold on. Okay, there you are. Can you see how it sparkles now? Look how nice they came out. They're really, really pretty. I really like the way that looks. So you see how shiny they are? So we gessoed them first. Okay, Barry, thanks. We're almost done here. And so then this, I'll post the pictures on my blog, but look how sparkly she's starting to look. Her tail looks sparkly. This looks sparkly. It came out really cute. It's coming out cutie cute. Cute, cute, cute. So do you guys have any questions for me? And then where's the one we did tonight? She's starting to dry up. You can start to see the white edges here, where you can see it's starting to dry. That's okay, Barry. So, and there she is. There's our one with the face. So do you guys have any questions? So don't forget to go on my blog, leave a comment there, and you have a chance to win stencils, since we did work with stencils tonight and we were doing mixed media. So you have a chance to win this. Thank you, Barry. This from Prima and these stencils. So leave a comment on my blog and then I will pick a winner till Tuesday and I'll pick a winner. Thank you, Renee. I really like the way it's coming out. I think it's really pretty. I'm going to add some more stuff on it and I'll probably stamp a little bit. I'll color the seahorses, but I just love the way these shells came out tonight. They really, really look pretty. All painted and sparkly. Aren't they pretty? I really like it. If you could see the shine, I mean, it's so shiny and sparkly. I wish you could see it. Can you see there? Yeah, it's very pretty. All right, have a good night, everyone. No questions? Thanks, Dawn, posting a blog. Thanks for Dawn. Thank you, Darcy. Thanks, Barry and Dawn, for hanging out with me. Everyone hanging out with me. Them moderating for me. It was a lot of fun, and I want to do some more canvases. Like I said, the next time we'll do it where I actually show you how to make the eyes and how to make the nose and the mouth. But that alone, just the face, takes a long time. I'm surprised that we finished this much, so. Thank you, Bunny. Thanks. Thanks, Marilyn. Oh, you, my pleasure, Renee. All right, guys, have a good night, and then I will see you. Thank you, Mitz. I will see you next week. What else is on? Anybody else on? Well, I'll probably see you at Catherine's tomorrow, and then at Kathy's. Thanks, Dawn. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. Oh, you guys are so sweet. Thank you. All right, good night, everyone. Bye.